Welcome back. Before we go any further, I want you to take a look at this video. What has happened is that this video is from Mumbai, and this is what happened when a marshal stopped a lady and wanted to impose a fine for not wearing a mask. Listen. That was a marshal. She stopped this lady, wanted to impose a fine. Remember, this is Mumbai, this is Maharashtra, where this state has consistently seen high number of COVID cases. They wanted to impose a fine, and this is what the marshals got in return. These people who, number one, are defaulters, and then number two, who behave like this, are far away from COVID-appropriate behavior. And they are the problem, not part of the problem. And this is why we are seeing an uptick once again. No amount of vaccine will be able to help if we don't have a change in this attitude. There was a reason why we paused and let you watch this picture. Because this is the picture which defines very, very clearly the problem that we are facing as of this moment. But what really are the demands of the states as far as vaccination is concerned? COVID-appropriate behavior and educating people on the importance is a different chapter. But on vaccination, where do the states stand? I would like to introduce Dr. Rahul Pandit. He's a member of the Maharashtra COVID Task Force. He's with us. We also have Dr. Mohammad Ashil, Executive Director of the Kerala Social Security Mission, and also the core team member of the COVID control in the state. We also have Dr. Rahul Sharma, Director and Head of Department of Pulmonary and Critical Care at Lecrest Hospital in Ghaziabad. Thank you very much to all of you all. In just a short moment, we'll have Dr. Arun Mitra as well. Dr. Pandit, let's begin with you first. Yes, of course, you have a problem on, of COVID-appropriate behavior. This is a big, big challenge always and all the time and will continue to remain so, right? You can't change people overnight. Or you just can't change people sometimes. But the point, Dr. Pandit, is in terms of vaccination, what really is the demand that a state like Maharashtra is going to place? Before I go to Dr. Pandit, I believe we've lost that connection on him. Let me ask this question of Dr. Sharma. Dr. Sharma, you know, I'm sure COVID-appropriate behavior is a problem in Uttar Pradesh also. I'm sure these are similar problems people face everywhere. I want to know from you, vaccine being a tool available to one and all, how appropriately should it be used? What's your reading?
So I think these are two most important questions that we need to address. One is the COVID appropriate behavior, and the other one is vaccination. So we need to keep this in mind that vaccination is not 100% preventive. It has some limitation and it is not widespread spread in India till now. The coverage is still very, very less. So COVID appropriate behavior is the only way right now when we are seeing that so
not
many
even
patients and so many vaccine, still the time it covers at least 70-80% of the population. You need to have this COVID appropriate behavior. It is not like that some people are getting vaccine and everybody is getting relaxed that yes, the vaccine has arrived and we are safe. This behavior has to be changed. We need to see that everywhere the cases are rising just because of one reason, that we are not following COVID appropriate behavior. You have already shown in that picture that people are so adamant, people are so reluctant to use even a single mask despite we have seen so
no,
many
but in Dr. Sharma, fine.
Such
I mean,
a
people,
bad
yeah, you have to get people to follow COVID appropriate behavior. But you know, the other point also is, say, in a state like Uttar Pradesh, from where you have your hospital, is that the Prime Minister, no less, pointed out two faults, right? Fault number one is lack of adequate testing, or the correct and appropriate testing, which is the RT-PCR. UP still largely goes with rapid antigen test. And then secondly is vaccine wastage. I mean, it's just criminal to think that a scarce commodity like the vaccine, which is so, so scarce, is also being wasted. 17%, in the case of UP, around 10%.
I think these are again important questions. As far as testing is concerned, we are telling it repeatedly that since the COVID has started in India or in the world, testing is the most important and sole criteria to identify cases early, because most of the patients are still asymptomatic and they are probably the people who are spreading this disease.
Sure.
As far as vaccine is concerned, it is again a very, very important commodity, which we probably is the most important thing we were in the last 1 year, and it has to be used appropriately. I would like to mention one thing here. Since it is in a rollout phase where health workers were given vaccine first, and now it is for 60 above 60 and 45 plus you know, the comorbidities.
Yeah.
But I think it has to be rapidly spread to each and every person who
Correct.
Wants to get
Correct.
This vaccination, because
Correct.
it this is not the way. When our cases are rising, I think everybody should have liberty to go and get himself vaccinated.
Okay, Dr. Pandit.
That way only it will.
Absolutely, that way it will get under control. But the government says, and representatives say, that you know, we've got a demand and supply situation to match, and that's the real problem. Dr. Pandit, I want to come back to you now. You know, you are part of the Maharashtra COVID Task Force. This is one state which has always been the biggest challenge, and also has fought the COVID-19 most, far more than any other state. Now, what do you think as far as vaccination is concerned? COVID-appropriate behavior, we've discussed enough. It needs to be there. But in terms of vaccination, what needs to be done, Dr. Pandit?
Thank you very much for having me on the show. And I'm sorry there was some technical
Not
glitch.
A problem, sir.
Look, I think the problem here is that we have to run both the programs parallelly. So vaccination program needs to be opened up. Right now, the demographic which we are actually vaccinating, 60 plus and 45 with comorbidities, is definitely going to save the lives, because we know that if you look at the mortalities, 80% of the patients actually fall into this category. But to break the chain, we need to vaccinate those people who are actually stepping out of the house right now. And it's not the 60 plus who are stepping out of the house. It is the people who are younger, maybe from 20 to 50 years of age, who are actually venturing out of the house, going for their work. Not that they're going out for fun, but they're going out for their work. And that's where the COVID-appropriate behavior is also low. We need to open up the vaccination pretty quickly, ramp it up. I know there may be problems with the dosage availability and rest of the infrastructure being put up. But I think we need to ramp it up to a point where we can actually vaccinate both the groups, so that we can break the chain, at the same time save the life. That's one thing. The second thing is, we need to make vaccine accessible. We need to be making it accessible to the doorstep. You know, people right now have to come to a hospital, stand in a queue. If we can set up vaccination centers or booths or mobile vans with some, like an ambulance with an ICU facility in that, which has got a resuscitation bay in there, in each and every corner of the state or the city, people will walk in very quickly and there won't be any crowd as well on a particular center. Plus the rural area we need to think of. Maharashtra, the problem this time is that a lot of people are actually positive in the rural area. How much is the penetration in the rural area of vaccine awareness? That needs to be also taken into consideration. We have a good pediatric vaccination program going on, and that is what we need to basically rely on. We need to go on the same principles, and the pediatric vaccination program is go home and vaccinate, which Correct. May not be practical now, but go to the mohalla, go to the community, go to the village panchayat office, set up a makeshift vaccination camp with the bare minimum facilities which the government has mandated and actually vaccinate people. I think that's what we need to do.
Okay. Dr. Ashil, let's listen to your experience also and your suggestions. You're the executive director of the Kerala Social Security Mission and also part of the COVID control team member. You're a core team member. Kerala has also been one of those states that has seen high COVID numbers. What do you think needs to be done as far as vaccination is concerned? Apart from the fact that, see, now that you know that the government's main concern is that we don't have enough vaccines. If we open it up for all, there'll be a shortage. And then there'll be a very, very difficult situation. So then, what are the solutions?
Let's go by numbers. Actually, what's the strategy of India per se in dealing with COVID-19? The vaccination policy is that not like many other countries, we are really going for creating a herd immunity through vaccination. As Dr. Rahul Pandit sir has clearly mentioned, what is the strategy India has adopted is that we are focusing on the people who are potentially more risky, more chance of dying due to COVID-19, or people who are at more risk. That's the people who are whom we are targeting at. Even if you go by that target, we have a target of around 30 crore people whom to be vaccinated before July 31st. That was our target. So if you look at the 30, if you have to vaccinate 30 crore people before July 31st, we must be vaccinating at least 30 lakh people per day. So if you look at the figures in India, it's around coming around 17 lakh people per day as of now. And however, we have touched that 30 lakh mark in on Monday of this week. Actually, on 15th, we have touched that 30 lakh mark. But after that, we have actually come down. And if you look at now, it's around 17 to 18 lakh per day is the number of vaccinations which is happening in pan India. If you look at as clearly mentioned by Rahul Pandit sir, the strategy here is that we have been actually the vaccination sites. If you look at, if there are around 41,000 vaccination sites, of which only 6,000 is in the private sector. So if we have to decentralize this the entire system, the state must be given enough freedom to do that. Actually, we have enough legacy of doing kind of a polio vaccination. We have legacy of doing MR, measles, rubella vaccination. India has a good legacy.
No, do you think, Dr. Ashil, see, so, the concern over here is that you cannot expect suddenly for those many vaccine vials or dosages being available just like that. It's not possible. The best of the facilities in the world cannot provide. So do you think that this is a concern which the government should have thought of in advance, perhaps planned better? I understand you can't just start manufacturing. There is a proper procedure in place. It takes many, many years. There has to be a proper system in place. But the fact that we are behind schedule on the existing vaccines is also a telling story and a point of concern.
Yeah, if you look at the stock of vaccine in India, to date, if you look at the stock of vaccine in India, we have enough vaccine to actually speed up. The Honorable Prime Minister's meeting day before yesterday also cleared that we have enough vaccines in stock to initially ramp up our vaccination campaign. The problem primarily I see is in the implementation part, not just in the stock. If you look at the stocks in India, we have actually said that we will not be exporting the vaccines till we have, as we have a shortage. So if you look at, there are many curbs of exporting of also now. So we may be having, there would be a small shortage, but I don't think that it is the primary factor which is actually stopping us from accelerating the campaign. Okay. The primary thing I would suggest is that, I would think is that, as Rahul sir has said, that the implementation part, it should be, enough freedom should be given. For example, we were actually in Kerala, we were trying to vaccinate entire people in the homes, like old age homes. Old age homes, we thought of vaccinating every person. That we have 619 old age homes, of which there are 19,800 old age elderly. So we thought of vaccinating everyone. But the problem here is that many of our people in old age home may not be having an ID card. But we need a photo ID card to be incorporated to get in the vaccines. So there are similar small things which a small predicament at the administrative and managerial level, which can be entrusted on the states. For example, if you give a set of vaccines, say that if a state is given a set of vaccines, the team in that state actually knows that, how to actually do that. So I think though the mechanism of actually going through the COVID software has many advantages, one primary thing that which is blocking the pace of the delivery is also the software part. We need to be actually doing a campaign when it should be the secondary thing.
Okay.
When the software should not drive a campaign.
Okay.
Campaign should be driven by the science of it.
Okay. Dr. Arun Mitra is also with us, Senior Vice President, Indian Doctors for Peace and Development, joins us from Punjab. Dr. Mitra, good evening. I want to ask you what according to you, could be the possible solutions to have jabs for all and soon? How can it be done? What are you hearing in Punjab?
See, firstly, I would say that Punjab is in a very peculiar situation. I am just coming from Tikri border, where we go every week to give medical aid to the farmers, and we have examined thousands of patients. People are living in tractor trolleys together with unknown people, and there is hardly any COVID to be seen. I have no answer to that. Even in the poor areas, which are densely populated, you will hardly find COVID in Punjab. It's basically middle class and upper class disease in Punjab, at least. I don't know about other states. So the upper class and the middle class, they are now getting vaccinated themselves. Of course, the number is less so far. It has to be, people have to be convinced that vaccine will save their lives. They will not be, even if they are getting infected, they won't be so serious, or the fatality would be reduced. That only can help the middle class and the upper classes, economically, the upper classes, to get vaccinated. They are accepting the vaccine by and large in Punjab.
No, but Dr. we have Mitra, to go more. Yes. Don't you think that this will automatically create, in terms of policy building, a sort of a class divide? That just because in rural parts of India you do not see, and this, by the way, the CSIR DG, Dr. Mande, it was his study, in his paper he suggested, he said that it appears as if the parts where general hygiene standards were poor, people had greater immunity, and thus they were saved by this, they did not get the coronavirus. Don't you think that there has to be parity? So what if it is not spreading right now in rural areas? What if it does?
We have been having linear falls in September, and now there is sudden surge. Even the surge was expected in November and December also, but it did not happen. Whether it will happen in rural areas or in the poor areas, we do not know as yet. In fact, we should try to give vaccine to everyone that is there. But the poor people or the rural people, they are not ready to accept. They say, where is the way?
Sure.
Where is the COVID amongst us? Where is the COVID? The domestic workers who come to our homes, whom we had forbidden earlier to enter our homes, fearing that they will carry the COVID infection to our houses, in the middle class houses. Now those women are saying, we have been carrying COVID from your house to our people. I mean, the reverse thing. This is a very strange phenomenon. But I agree that there has to be a penalty in vaccination. But there is definitely a class divide. We may not see the class, divide, but it is seen.
Sure.
That
the class division should not exist as far as policy formulation is concerned. It may or may not exist in the society. One really can't comment. But doctor, as long as governments don't divide on the basis of on class, then I think we are in a good place. Dr. Pandit, very quickly, the last word. Obviously, we have to vaccinate everyone, and we have to do it fast. I mean, you look at the way the figures are rising, it's very clear that there is a surge, and we still haven't seen the second peak. It's coming, right? So what exactly needs to be done? We just a short while ago had experts who said that, fine, have jabs for all, but also clear more vaccines. There are many vaccine candidates. So once you follow due diligence, the due process, then the drug controller can clear more vaccines.
Correct. Absolutely. I think we have many more vaccine candidates. The Sputnik vaccine is there. You have the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, which is basically going to be available. And you have the Pfizer and Moderna, which have got its own technical challenges in terms of infrastructure, which it requires for a deep freezer refrigeration. But I think if we clear up more vaccine candidates and have the vaccines available, more doses will be available for people. And obviously, the need for vaccination would be there. What I still feel is that we need to actually create more and more vaccine awareness. As you rightly said, that we are behind the schedule for the current one. And there are two reasons for that. we have not reached to the doorstep of the people to vaccinate, and we have not done enough yet to actually to promote the vaccination program, that everybody needs to do it. If you look at the queues in Mumbai city, and I can only talk about Mumbai city right now, it's the upper middle class and the middle class people who are queuing up at the centers. I'm not really seeing the same amount of enthusiasm in the lower strata of the society. And there is a vaccine hesitancy there, or there may be a bit of complacency that, yes, it will come. We will just follow up. Why to go into a crowd right now? We will just wait and see. So that kind of attitude may also be there. But we need to do more to actually vaccinate.
Okay.
All three things need to be done.
Absolutely. Dr. Pandit, Dr. Ashil, Dr. Mitra, as well as Dr. Sharma, thank you very much for joining us. We come to the end of this part of The Big Fight, but news continues on the other side. Stay with us.